USA action. Now in the ring to my left, from New York City, weighing 225 pounds, Tony Leone. And ladies and gentlemen, here he is in the ring to my right, from Quebec City, Quebec, weighing 235 pounds. You see the belt, the AWA heavyweight champion of the world, Rick Martel. Your referee, Bob Grazinger.
Well, Rick Martel, being one of the great ones, AWA World's Heavyweight Champion, in here with Mr. Leone. And I just say, because I would, one match I would someday hope to see is that title match between the National Wrestling Alliance champion, Ric Flair, and Rick Martel, if those two men are still title holders at that particular point in time.
Wouldn't that be something?
Yeah, I'd love to see it.
That would be an earth-shattering event. I don't know if it could ever be put together, but as wrestling fans, we'd have to hope so. And Rick Martel going right to work and slamming down Tony Leone. Once and twice, that was hard, and Leone bails out.
That ring is certainly hard, and Martel had him way, way up in the air. Those slams do take it out of you. Getting back to that subject of...
Up and over. There he goes, flipping him over the ropes. Quick takedown by Martel, and he goes right to work on the left arm of Tony Leone.
Well, we've seen the likes of the National Wrestling Alliance champion, Ric Flair, again, who is a style just a little bit different than Martel's, but it'll be a great match to see. Great back suplex, Doug.
Martel got a quick cover, but Leone kicked out of it in one count. And so Rick Martel will go back to work on the arm, but Leone with a knee, elbow slam, and that backs Martel off in a hurry. Just rakes the thumbs over the eyes. Backing him in the corner. Jam-packed crowd here to watch this as Martel and Leone, who if you very happen to be watching Milwaukee, Green Bay, Dallas, Chicago, New York City, we're glad you're here. Great wrestling action, and there's the AWA heavyweight belt holder, Rick Martel, working on Tony Leone in the center of the ring.
The great Leo Namolini, who once held the football player, the San Francisco 49ers, once held the National Wrestling Alliance Championship. I heard him comment on Rick Martel, saying he's got to be one of the great ones.
Certainly, he's going to go down, and when you look back over history a few years from now, they're going to still be talking about Rick Martel, who's got Leone back on the side of the canvas, and Leone grabs onto the rope, and Martel will break at the behest of referee Bob Grazinger. Now Leone gets the wrist lock onto Martel, right on the ropes. Martel actually hanging onto the ropes for a moment, backed into the corner, and the hold broken by Leone.
The great Bronco Nagurski, of course, the football player out of the Chicago Bears, University of Minnesota, was the world's heavyweight champion for the National Wrestling Alliance at one time. Weighed 237 at his prime, just about the same weight as Rick Martel and Ric Flair.
And one of the all-time greats. There's a kick out of the corner by Martel. Ambushes Leone, gets him over, but Leone drapes that leg over the lower rope, and Martel, hanging on for dear life, finally has to break the hold. Up again, Martel poised, watching.
We have a very good referee in this match, Bob Grazinger, former professional hockey player.
Now Martel, look at that, great combination, and down goes Leone.
And Bob Grazinger out of the University of Denver.
Martel working still on the left arm of Tony Leone from New York City. Leone in pain, Martel turns it around, grabs, pulls in that hammerlock, turns it again right in the center of the ring, and Leone can't seem to twist out of it. Finally goes to the rope, and the best he can do to get out of that hold, Bergdani, is to throw a leg over, because Rick really had it.
Yeah, when Rick clamps on, he's got the powerful, powerful hands and grip. I don't know how he developed it. Look at Leone here, going to work on him.
A plate choke. Smashing away, but Martel comes roaring right back out of the corner.
Look at that French temper going. And he got it going the way it looked here.
That is good and bad for Rick Martel. Sometimes it gets the best of him, but boy, when it gets going low.
Look at that tremendous move by Martel.
Oh, my.
Oh, there he went for the punch. And over. There's the pin, maybe. Two, three.
Beautiful. Gorgeous, gorgeous move. As a former wrestler, I loved it.
Corner, AWA
And you see the result now. Leone still isn't going anywhere. Tony Leone.
It was devastating, to say the least.
Martel, Tony, with a combination of moves. Here you see it.
Missed that forearm or punch. First down on the knee. Ordinarily let him go, but he developed it back into this. Back body drop. Phenomenal move.
Tremendous.
Look at the bridge.
1-2 combination, and that's the end of the line.
Rick Martel, if you will. Rick, you've got to be very disappointed, disqualified. A lot of people think Garvin may have intentionally hopped over that top.
What I am right now is frustrated. I had this man beat. Everybody saw it in the middle length. I had him beat. I had him where I wanted. He had Precious, his valet, get involved. Well, that saved him. Well, I have been in that situation before. But those people were men. I grab him by the neck and I slap him around. I take care of the problem myself. But this man's hiding behind a woman. Well, Garvin, you got a rematch now. I've got you in the ring, and you have the title on the line. I'm going to get you back for it, and I've got a special plan for that Precious. I'm going to get her out of the way somehow, and this time it's going to be you and I, and I'm going to take care of you real good.
All wrestling fans, highly unusual, Rick Martel challenging a challenger, Jimmy Garvin. We'll be back. All right, wrestling fans, with me now, AWA heavyweight champion Rick Martel. And fans, coming up on that great Pro Wrestling USA card, Saturday night, March 23rd, New Haven Veterans Coliseum. Rick, you've got your wish, but you have gorgeous Jimmy Garvin back in the ring. Highly unusual one for you to be challenging a challenger. But Rick, in your agitated state, the way you feel about Jimmy Garvin, are you certain you're making the right decision?
Yes, sir. Finally, I got him in the ring. I got him what I wanted, right here in New Haven. You know, Ken, what this man has done to me, you know, inside, I feel it. Like, I'm so upset, I want to scream. But I'm not going to, you know, I have to be in control. Because, you know, the World Championship is too much. There's too much at stake for me to lose control. But this man, he's been getting away with too much. Now, I've got him back now. And, you know, back in the Meadowlands, I had him beat. I had him where I wanted. And this man got away with using his valet. His valet got involved with the match. But I have a big, big surprise for the people. Right here on this program next week, the AWA will announce a big, big surprise. And that involves Precious. And believe me, he's going to be in for a big surprise. I got him where I want.
All right, Rick, can you give us any kind of inkling what this surprise is going to be?
No, sir. The people will tune in to this program next week, and they'll find out. And Jimmy Garvin, I got you exactly where I want, and you're going to pay for it. And right now, I would like to introduce this man. I'm very proud of him. He's a hometown boy from here, right in New Haven. Jerry Oski. And I've seen this man. I've seen his first match in Montreal. And believe me, this man has come a long way. And the people will be proud of him right here.
All right, Jerry, great to have you here with us on Pro Wrestling USA.
Well, thank you very much. It's a pleasure to be here. And you know, that's why we are here, because this is the best in championship wrestling, the AWA, right here.
All right, fans, remember, Saturday, March 23rd, Veterans Coliseum. Get tickets now.